And up next, we move on to our final presenter, Bom Rachawong Ditnada Disakun, represented Thailand in several international meetings to present the Thai ways of sustainable development based on His Majesty the King's sufficiency of economy. He is currently holding many key positions of important rural development organizations, and he also served as the private secretary to Her Royal Highness the Princess Mother, the late mother of His Majesty the King of Thailand since 1967, and became the Secretary General of Mae Fa Luang Foundation and the Royal Patronage, or MFLF, since its establishment in 1975 to improve the livelihood of underprivileged communities. Presently, he is a chairman of the MFLF board, and in addition to pioneering the foundation's Doi Tung development project since 1988, he has led the foundation to implement sustainable alternative livelihood development projects internationally. In Myanmar, in Afghanistan, and in Aceh, Indonesia. As chairman of the Royal Initiative Discovery Institute, he is currently working on bringing the above development principles into implementation nationwide. Ladies and gentlemen, Mom Rachawong Ditnada Disakun.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I think I came to the wrong place. I'm not a woman, but they had two ladies who were the greatest speakers that I kind of afraid to get up here today. Secondly, I'm ill, and I'm not really prepared. So please do excuse me. Anyway, I thank Dr. Chirayu, Chulalongkorn, and all the stakeholders that put this meeting together. And I would like to share my experience with you all. The SDGs, the global agenda for the next 15 years, emphasizes highly on sustainability, resilient, equity, and including growth. From 70 years of non-stop working on the ground to improve the livelihood of the people, His Majesty the King has provided a concrete model and evidence of successful projects fulfilling the SDGs. Her Royal Highness the Princess Mother, the founder of the Mae Fa Luang Foundation, learned from His Majesty the King, that means her son, and implemented at Doi Tung development project in 1988. Doi Tung was the heart of the notorious Golden Triangle, once the world's biggest opium producer and trafficking route. The area has about 24 kilometers with the Myanmar bordering and about 11,000 inhabitants of six ethnic minority groups, mostly Arab immigration, and had no Thai ID card. We inherited multi-dimensional problems, may them be opium cultivation, trafficking, and addiction. The presence of the militia groups and armed trafficking. Environment degradation from slash and burn cultivation. Lack of infrastructure and sense of insecurity and belonging. People live without hope and future. The Princess Mother believed that nobody wants to be bad, but they cannot afford to be good. Therefore, our mission is to help people to help themselves and enable them and nature to coexist in harmony. People are the key to sustainable development. Therefore, empowerment and ensuring that they are resilient and capable of carrying on the development is vital, and it takes time. We learned from His Majesty the King and adopted His people-centric approach into what we call the 3S model. And we created this long before Steve Jobs. But Steve Jobs got rich, but we are not. We divided development into three phases: survival, sufficiency, and sustainability. What do you mean by the first S, survival? You people in this room don't understand it. Because the people that I work with, they don't even know where they're going to get the next meal. You see, we're in so different world. But I have to express this sort of things to you so that you really realize that how unfortunate you are sitting in this room and have all this job and have all this opportunity. So the first S is so important. You have to make the people, the mouth and stomach, to fulfill this first. Before you can talk about anything else, maybe be the banking, all right, or maybe about religion. One has to be able to live, to survive. That's the most important thing. Law, orders, forget about it. It doesn't serve the point. So that is the first thing. Since most of the people are farmers, majority of the people, we usually start with the irrigation and soil improvement. The productivities and the quality of crops is going to be better and better. When we started at Doi Tung, opium farmers were hired as forestry workers. They were paid with cash daily. I do have to pay it daily, just like you. Why? They believe when they receive the money. The talking alone and monthly, forget it. Daily. And I like your expression very much. The first day, what you do is pay them. And that it will be forever, reminding them all the time. We also here pay them daily, three times, and what they got is three times more than what they earn from opium. If they don't earn from more than opium, why should they come and join us? So whatever they do with us, we have to provide them with a better income and quality of life. Then we train them on higher and more intricate skill in agriculture on a job training basis. They became gardeners, cut flowers and orchid growers, and for those who could read and write, they can work with us at the tissue culture lab. For the best of the best gardeners, I encourage them to become entrepreneurs, owning nurseries. So you don't have to come and be my staff. Encourage them and set them up as a social enterprise. Very small social entrepreneur, just like Yunus has been doing, so on. So I think similar things that we're doing together, but I'm doing it very holistically. So are you too, you know. But I think the two ladies, later on, we have to sit down and talk about it, because we have a lot of synergy that we can put it together and make it better and better for all of us and the world. To provide long-term and sustainable or stable income for the people, we initiated for economic forestry of Arabica coffee and macadamia nuts, as they are suitable to the area, have high value addition, and can maximize their potential in the long run. When the people have enough income, they no longer encroach the forest. We have big problem about denuded land. All the forest has been denuded. If you fly by helicopter from Mang Son right down to Lui province, it's all denuded. And that's because of the human being. So we, at Doi Tung, Her Royal Highness, has started on the reforestation. Economic forest is therefore a buffer zone that allows people and nature to coexist in harmony. Growing high-value crops requires the whole production process, training from growing trees to brewing coffee, all of which render them into becoming coffee entrepreneur or any kind of entrepreneur with the skills they require. The second S is sufficiency. What do you mean by sufficiency? Here, there's a clear increase in living standards that we can measure. People have steady income and are able to pay off some of or even all the debts. And I don't know about Taiwan and also Bangladesh, but here in Thailand, we have loan shark. And these people, if they are able to pay back to the loan shark, which cost them monthly, not 25 cents, 20% interest rate per month. We should kill all these people. We should. You see? So if these people that are working with us are able to pay back the loan shark, happiness. You can feel the happiness, you see? So I think this is the most important thing that on the sufficiency side. They become self-reliant, start to have enough, and to know what happiness is. To drive to this phase, our strategy is to use business model to establish sustainable income. We group produce and products of the first phase into four businesses: food, handicrafts, horticulture, and tourism, leading to the creation of Doi Tung brand. As a result, we actually are the first social enterprise in Thailand. We look into the lives of men and women of all ages to study what was the traditional skill and wisdom they have. Don't have to start a new thing, you know, or create anything. Go back to the past, to the people, what they're good at, and build on what they have. That's all. You don't have to be bright or, you know, all these, I don't know, technologies and so on and so forth. Go back to the past and build on what we have. We brought in designers, appropriate technologies and quality control. We changed from product-driven to market-driven approach. Here are examples of our handicraft products, spanning from textile, homeware, mulberry paper, ceramic, and ready-to-wear. The third S is sustainability. Doi Tung now is in this stage where the people become fully independent, have savings, enough to develop immunity to external shocks, and can continue to develop themselves. And this is what I call true sustainability. The 3S model not only provides options for the people to live at or near home, but lessen problems like migration into big cities, human trafficking, forced labor, and sex industry, even slum, by addressing them at this root cause. Before I forget, the 17 development goals, they forgot one thing. The UN, they think they're smart, but they're not. Well, take a look what I'm trying to say. You know what it is? They forgot about migration. Take a look at the 17 goals. They forgot about migration. Look at the migration in America. They're all migrants in America. Look at the migration in Europe now. This is the biggest thing that's going to happen in the whole world, and it's going to affect everyone in this world. So this is something, you know, you from the UN, you better take that note. That I look down on the UN on this matter. You see? So the three models that I said, you know, it's not provide options for the people to live near home and do the migrations and so on. And this is the root cause. Let me go on a little bit. Can I have a little bit more than 10 minutes? Let me get into this. What happens with Saddam Hussein? What happens Gaddafi, Osama bin Laden? They all CIAs. And who started the CIA? Look at Syria, Libya. Anywhere that you talk about in the Middle East and so on and so forth, in Africa and so on. Who did it? And you talk about migration. That's not the point. The point, the grassroots are in those countries that the Westerner did it. So when you talk about all this sustainable development, another point that you miss out in the SDG. Oh, you check, huh? All right. You check another one. Why don't you talk about weapons? All right. Look. I'm stopping here. But I say the 17 point is not right. And this is Bandai, the Westerners. So I think it's time now, because of the socialism, communism, socialism, and capitalism fail. If it doesn't fail, why the world is like this? So it failed. That's why the 21st century, something has to happen. The new ism is coming up. What is it? I don't know. But it's around here. In the East. So everyone has to look East in the future. Okay? Throughout 27 years or 28 years that I have been through Doi Tung, whatever we do, we always ask ourselves, what do the people get out of it? Every cent and dime that you put in there, what do the people get out of it? If you cannot measure, don't ever give the money to them. That is what I'm trying to tell you, is that don't look in the input and output, but look at the outcome. This is very crucial. A lot of people talk in Bangkok and just shove it down and let the people do it. They don't want to do it. Oh, I can talk for years on this matter, but anyway. Well, when you talk about Doi Tung, you know, economically per capita income, the people of Doi Tung has risen 20-fold. Okay? 20 times better off economically. In addition, the project has been self-sustained since the year 2000. We didn't get the money from any Thai people or any foreigners. We generate our income. That's why Mae Fah Lung Foundation stand on our own feet. If you got to talk your talk, have your walk. That's why today I can talk my talk, because I do have to walk my walk a long, long distance. Okay? Now, socially, the children receive minimum compulsory education. More and more of them continue to vocational school or college and university level. Even the fast-changing world, people still conserve their art, tradition, and beliefs. Environmentally, the forest area has been revived. Take a look at this Doi Tung. This is the past. And what is it now? You can see it's totally different. To elevate our work, we partner with well-established corporations like IKEA, Muji, Tokyo University, Caldi, Mi Cafeto, and Isimichu Ishimitsu, Japanese coffee expert, to improve our quality and standard to another platform and bring local products to global market, from local to global. But before you go from local to global, you have to bring the global to local first. Bring in all the international designers and those who know about the market. So as I said, you have to do the market-driven. Therefore, this is very, very important to work hand in hand. As a result, we received recognition from UNODC, Schwab Foundation, Nikkei Asia Prize, and Thailand Premium Products. Sustainability also means that the model can be adapted and implemented anywhere, not only Thailand alone. Thailand is now exporting sustainable development model to the world with a G2G agreement, and we have implemented projects, as you have said, you know, in Myanmar, Afghanistan, Indonesia, as well as other areas in Thailand. For example, in Nan province, the watershed area of Thailand, where we implemented full-scale development and now become the national model for the reforestation. We do it as a catalyst, and the government learned from us, and then we try to embed it into the government. It's not our duty for the foundation to run the country, huh? It's the government. They're being paid for it, but they don't know how to do it because all the government officials, they are handcuffed. So many things because regulations, rules, and whatnot. So we try to do out of the box and let them learn from us and adapt rules, regulation, and laws even so that they be able to do it. Nowadays, our approach, based on the King's wisdom, has been adopted by the United Nations General Assembly under the UN Guiding Principles for on Alternative Development. I've been doing that for 10 years at the UN. We are also working with equal partnership with the German government through the GIZ to be their consultant and on development. Yesterday, they brought the Center Bureau of Narcotics of India to Daitung to see and understand our development approach with the aim to apply the model in India. And this is going to be the software from the Thai side and the hardware, that means cash-wise, from the German, and we're working trilateral in India. And maybe in the very near future in Guatemala and also in Morocco and also in Iran, that they wish us to go and help them. In Thailand, through the Royal Initiative Discovery Foundation that Dr. Chirayu and I started together with bringing all the royal families' foundations together, we have embedded development approach based on our experience and lessons learned, which led by the King's best practice on sufficiency economy into national policy. This is very important, and I'm so glad and proud that I have a part in this. This year, we implement the four Ps: public-private people partnership to shift 1/3 of our country, covering about 22,000 villages, working very, very closely with the Ministry of Interior. We shift our country to another paradigm to foster sustainable development DNA into the future generation. We have Rakao Foundation, working with 175 universities in Thailand to bring students out of their classroom and learn from the reality on the ground and work with universities, executives, professors to change their curriculum, change the curriculum in university so that the research to be more beneficial to the people and the country in a sustainable manner. In conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you that the SDGs are achievable. Thailand has been working on addressing these issues starting 70 years ago and learned by doing lots of mistakes and adjust them all along during the 70 years. And today, Thailand is a donor country. I said this at the UNGAS that I was able to represent Asia Pacific in the Roundtable 5 in UNGAS in April. And I said that Thailand is a donor country. And I said 4 or 5 issues that the UN must pay attention. If you like to see that, then you try to get into this website and so on. Anyway, on a personal level, these projects may seem a bit too big and slightly out of reach. But let me tell you, they are not. You can also make a difference. Any one of you sitting down here can make the difference. SDGs are not only for governments or corporations. It is not. But they are for all of us to follow, each individually. How we live our lives depend who we are as individuals. So we must live our lives responsibly. The world is at its tipping point. I really mean it. The world is at its tipping point, and it's heading towards a state of collapse. I'm not joking. We see that we are part of the problems, which means that we are also part of the solution. It is time for us to act on it as our Mother Earth stops to compromise. And she's holding our grand and great-grandchildren hostage. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Pom Rajawong Dit Nadda Disukun.